Hey, this is Trevor Paulson from Adobe Analytics Product Management. In this video, I'm going to demo for you Customer Journey Analytics' new capability of audience publishing to the Adobe Experience Platform Unified Profile. This is really cool because it allows you to take interesting audiences or segments of users and push them into the Adobe Experience Platform Unified Profile for activation using Adobe CDP. Or journey optimization using Adobe Journey Optimizer. Let's get started. I'm going to drag in the product name dimension and my orders metric. This lets me see all of the most popular products sold on AdobeStore.com. It's Adobe's website for buying corporate gear. In this case, I'm interested in filtering it down to Adobe's pillows because at my desk, I like to make pillow forts. You can see the most popular products are Illustrator Pillow, followed by InDesign Pillow, followed by Photoshop Pillow. What I want to do is I want to target everyone who saw any of these three pillows to make sure that we can bring them back if they didn't actually buy it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on these three pillows and create an audience from that selection. Now you can see it's automatically created a filter for me and put it into the brand new audience builder. I'm going to name my audience Pillow Product Window Shoppers because it's targeting everyone that saw any of those three pillows. Now, you'll notice that in this UI, we have a host of new options that have never been available in segment publishing from Adobe Analytics. First of all, you'll see that we give a friendly description of what this audience is. Sometimes it's easy to get confused about what exactly an audience is doing. So this friendly description helps you understand that this audience will be published as a one-time collection of person IDs from a certain date range that equals the criteria of my filter. Next, you can select the refresh frequency. New to Customer Journey Analytics is a new type of audience called a one-time audience. A one-time audience allows you to publish this audience just once. This is really helpful if you have audiences that are tied to a specific promotional campaign or an event that happened once and won't happen again. In my case, I actually want to select a refreshing audience. A refreshing audience allows me to update the members of this audience every 4 hours, daily, weekly, or monthly. I'm going to select every 4 hours. Once selected, I can change the look-back window of that audience. I can also change when that audience will expire. When audiences expire, it'll send me an email letting me know that it's about to expire so that I don't miss out on refreshing it again if I need to. But you'll also notice that I might have missed something important. This is simply an audience of people who have viewed these pages, but I haven't yet excluded anyone that actually did buy the pillow. I only want to target people who saw those pages and didn't buy. So, one of the new features we've added to audience publishing in Customer Journey Analytics is the ability to mix and match multiple filters together to fine-tune your audience to meet your needs exactly. I'm going to drag in a filter that I created of people who never ordered. By dragging in this additional filter and anding it with my other filter, I can fine-tune my audience to just the people who saw the pillows that I'm interested in, but also never ordered. The ability to merge and mix filters in this way allows you to fine-tune your audience to either expand its reach for cases of marketing or narrow its focus down to just people that are most important. On the right-hand side, you can see we're adding in a rich set of preview metrics to help you get more information about this audience that you're about to publish. First, I can see the total number of people in my audience. This is really helpful when I'm trying to plan the marketing activities or retargeting activities that I'm going to take later on. But one of the most exciting things that we're now offering is some advanced machine learning that actually predicts how many of these audience members will actually come back to my site within the next 7 days. This is extremely helpful if I'm trying to retarget people who might come back to the site. It's not enough to know the total number of people in my audience without knowing how many of them will actually come back. You can see how many will come back within the next 7 days, the next 2 weeks, or even the next month. We'll provide a prediction for you so that you can find just the right audience to meet your needs. You'll also see that on the right-hand side, we provide a rich set of preview metrics for any metric that you want, no longer just events and sessions. By selecting this dropdown, I can pick any of the metrics that I have in my data view to see how this audience impacts any of them. For example, selecting the time spent metric. This allows me to see how much time this audience spends and what percent of the total time on my site they represent. This is really helpful because even if my audience is small, if they represent a large percentage of the total conversions on my site, I might want to pay special attention to them. One other additional useful feature we've added is the ability to view sample IDs that come from your audience. This allows me to spot check my audience to make sure that specific people that I expect to be in my audience are actually there. When I perform a search, we'll actually search against the entire unsampled set of IDs just to make sure that that audience member is actually present in my audience. You'll notice at the very bottom of the preview area, I can see the specific namespaces that are included by this identity, as well as the sandbox in the Adobe Experience platform that this audience will be published to. If I also happen to be using stitching on my CJA dataset, that works as well. So let's go ahead and publish my audience. One of the most exciting things about audience publishing in Customer Journey Analytics is the speed at which that audience will appear in the Adobe Experience platform. Unlike Adobe Analytics segment sharing, audience publishing in Customer Journey Analytics will appear in the Adobe Experience platform within a minute, depending on your audience size. When I head over to the segment builder in the Experience platform, you can see there's a brand new folder called CJA Audiences in the Audience section. When I click on that, you can see that my pillow product window shopper's audience is already available. It went just that fast. By dragging and dropping this audience into the segment builder, I can now create segments in the Adobe Experience platform for activation in all sorts of useful ways. I can even combine this audience with other attributes and data points that I have in the unified profile if I want. Looking at the segment summary, you can see I have 177 profiles that match this specific audience, which is great. That matched exactly the number of people that I had in Customer Journey Analytics. This segment can be used in all sorts of interesting ways, whether that's activating my audience using push messages, emails, or any of the other activation avenues I have in CDP, or whether that's including it in a journey optimization flow in Adobe Journey Optimizer. This allows Customer Journey Analytics to become a critical part of your relationship with your customers, allowing you to find useful audience segments for activation, optimization, and just making a better experience overall.